Good morning, friends, and welcome to the Morning Tales for June 27, 2019. So, guys, as we all are aware of the fact that current affairs not only helps in cracking the objective examination of phase 1 and phase 2, but the current affairs also help in cracking the phase 3, that is the interview round. So, do follow the current affairs through this Morning Tales series of ours. And now, let us begin our first question of the day, that is, what is the theme of Kargil Vijaya Diwas 2019. So as the name itself is explaining the purpose behind celebrating this day. So this Kargil Vijaya Diwas observes the victory of the Indian Army in Kargil War. And when is this day observed? So this day is observed on 26th July. Now this year is special. Why is 2019 special? Because this year marks the 20th anniversary of Kargil Vijaya Diwas. So it is the 20th anniversary year. Apart from this, another important question about this Kargil Vijaya Diwas is about the theme. So out of these five options, it is the option A, that is Remember, Rejoice and Renew, which has been selected as a theme for this day. Now, in order to make this day special, a 3-day long event is also being organized in Dras and in New Delhi. Dras is a town in Kargil itself, in Jammu and Kashmir. So with this, let's move on to the second question of today's Morning Tales, and that is, which company has developed the National Freight Index? So recently, a unique and one of its kind index, that is National Freight Index, has been released, which provides live freight rates for more than 7 million lanes and vehicle combination. So now this National Freight Index has been released by the startup Rivigo. Rivigo is a logistics startup which has released or developed this National Freight Index. Now, what is logistics? Logistics is the commercial activity of transporting goods from one place to the consumer market. Now, this National Freight Index, that is NFI, is based on the Rivigo's rate exchange. Basically, the parameters which have been taken for this index is based on the Rivigo's rate exchange. Now, another important fact about the freight market of India is that the size of the freight market is estimated at $150 billion to $160 billion. Basically, the freight market size in India is in the range of $150 billion to $160 billion. Now, another important fact about logistics market, or basically the transportation market, is that this logistics market account for nearly 14% of GDP. And out of this 14%, almost 70% is contributed by the road transportation. So guys, do remember this National Freight Index, because it is a unique kind of index which has been developed by Rivigo. So let's discuss our third question of the day, that is, which two countries have signed an MOU with India to broadcast Doordarshan DD India channel in their own countries? So these two countries are Bangladesh and South Korea. So these BTV World and KBS World have signed an MOU with Prasar Bharati to telecast the DD India channel in Bangladesh and South Korea. Now, as part of this MOU, the BTV World channel and KBS World channel will also be available on the DD Free Dish. Basically, it is a kind of exchange system in which BTV World and KBS World will be telecasted in India, and DD India, that is a channel of Doordarshan under the Prasar Bharati. Prasar Bharati is a broadcasting company and which is the regulator of Doordarshan channel, and these Doordarshan channels, DD India platform or the channel, will be broadcasted in Bangladesh and South Korea. So the other way around that the question can be made out of this information is that Doordarshan is the product of which company, or which of the following broadcasting companies operate the Doordarshan channel? So an important question it is. So do remember this question. Now let's move on to the next question of today's Morning Tales. Who has been elected as the new Director General of Food and Agricultural Organization? So this Food and Agriculture Organization is a specialized UN agency, United Nations agency, and recently it has concluded its election for the post of Director General. And the elections have been won by Qiu Dongyu, and he is the first Chinese to head the Food and Agriculture Organization. So remember this thing, that he has become the first Chinese to head FAO. Now the other way around that the question can be made out of this information is that who is the first Chinese head of FAO or the Director General of FAO? So the answer to that question is also Kyu Dong-yu. So let's move on to the next question. My Life, My Mission is the autobiography of, so there are five options: Narendra Modi, Amartya Sen, Baba Ramdev, Amitav Ghosh, Raghuram Rajan. Out of these options, it is the Baba Ramdev, as the picture is also hinting at that it is Baba Ramdev's autobiography, My Life, My Mission. So this autobiography has been co-authored by a senior journalist, Uday Mahurkar. So do remember this thing, that My Life and My Mission is the autobiography of Baba Ramdev, which has been co-authored by Uday Mahurkar. Because questions on books and their writers are very common to come in the examination. So from the exam point of view, it is important. Now let's move on to the next question. That is, who has won the 35th Men's Asian Snooker Championship 2019? So if you guys know who this person is, then you must have guessed the answer itself. So it is the picture of Pankaj Advani. So recently he has emerged as the winner in the 35th Men's Asian Snooker Championship, which was held in Doha, Qatar. Now another amazing and interesting fact about this marvelous player is that with this win, he has become the only player to win Asian and World Championships in all formats, in both billiards and snookers. Basically, with this win, Pankaj Advani has become the only player who has won the snooker and billiards championships at the Asian as well as the world level in all formats. And with this, let's move on to the last question of today, that is, which state has recently banned the felling of trees completely under the Forest Conservation Act 1980? This is the question for you guys that you have to mention in the comment section below, that which state has banned the felling of trees completely under the Forest Conservation Act. Now, I can give you the background of this question. So recently what has happened is that as many as 90 deaths have been caused in this state due to the severe heat waves and pollution. So in order to control the heat waves and pollution, the state in question has banned the felling of trees for all purposes. So from now on, anybody who would now want to cut a tree for even a development project also would have to translocate the tree in the same locality or in the other locality. So do mention your answers in the comment section below, that which state has recently banned the felling of trees. Thank you so much guys for watching our video. And if you have learned anything from the video, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Thank you so much.